as I lay me down. Heaven, hear me now. I'm lost without a cause. After giving it my all, winter storms have come and darkened my sun. After all that I've been through, who on earth can I turn to? I look to you. I look to you. After all my strength is gone, in you I can be strong. I look to you.
I took a breath. Suddenly there was pain, something that I had never known. But it opened my eyes and it opened my mouth. I had voice. I could see. I could feel. Instantly I wanted to touch, feel, and see everything around me. From the arms of the one who birthed me to the floor where I now could run, touch, feel, and see. Life given to me was all mine, and everything that I could see, I wanted to touch, feel. Is this for me? Labeled bad, I didn't care. Sit down right here in this chair, I didn't care. I never understood why everything had to be or couldn't be mine. Why did I have to sit down? Lesson I never had the ability to learn. Adverb, don't touch. I never had the ability to learn because I wanted to touch, feel, and see. I had a voice, you know. Some days I wanted all the things that normal would bring as my heart would reach for them. Then suddenly my eyes would draw me to see, touch, and feel all over again. Oh, what a wretched man I am. When I wanted to do right, evil was forever present. It taught me over and over again, as if I was on a merry-go-round. Touch, feel, don't you see? I had a voice, yes, I have voice. I called out, somebody help me please, teach me how to sit down. I cried to the one I heard my mama sing about over the kitchen sink. Oh, I had a voice, yes, Jesus, help me. Jesus, help me please to not touch, feel, or see. I want normal. He touched me. Taking two steps as a baby, I would fall. Shame would often be my companion until I heard, we fall down, but we get up. I would fall hard, but I had the strength to get back up again. I tried to fix everything my touching had broken. My time was running out. As the sand in the hourglass would show me, time to return from the place I had come. Who would save me? He heard me. He saved me. Back into the arms of the one who birthed me, with so many things to see, touch, and feel, I now sit down. I found normal. Jesus saves.
To you.
I'm here to tell you about my brother Timothy Johnson. The Johnson family had a loss last 2 weeks ago. It was my brother Timothy. He was one of the closest one in the Johnson family with each and every one of us. We was a close family. We grew up in Rochester, New York. We had one of those 7-bedroom houses with a whole lot of fun in it. My father was a good man when he got to Rochester, New York, and my mother was always at home helping out. She taught us. We had to sit at a table every day to have supper. We joked so much that my father used to say we laughed at everything. And Tim was one of the ones that always had a joke. And the thing about Tim, he loved life. He loved life at the most. And one thing about life, What he enjoyed, we enjoyed. We grew up as a close-knit family. One time, when something go wrong, we was already there to help each other out, don't care which way it goes. There was eight of us all together. Now we have lost the two youngest ones in the family. But Tim has always had a knack for working. When he got out of high school, he went to work for Weekly Asphalt. He loved that job. A lot of people worked for him, but they didn't like him because he was a hard boss. And I'll tell you one thing else about him. He went to work every day. He did what he had to do for his job. I'm the ones in the family, out of all my brothers, I never worked for him. I don't know why he wouldn't let me work for him. But the thing about it is this. In his life, he was always on the bottom end. Sometimes he did what he's supposed to do, but a lot of times he didn't do it. But the most important part about his life, when he found out that his sickness wasn't something that you walk away from easy. I prefer to talk more about his life as when he told me, say, bro, you know, I gave my life to the Lord. All those things that he did in his life, it only one thing that matters to me when he said, I give my life to the Lord. And the more pain came on me, he said, bro, pray for me. And I would pray for him. If he prays, say, pray for him while I'm right there, I put hands on him and pray for him. When he said he was in the hospital, he called sometime, he said, pray for me. What God gave him is what we all have before he left here, right? He was saved, sanctified, and filled with the Holy Spirit. Out of all the things he done in his life, that's the most important thing he did in his life. And by him being saved, sanctified, and filled with the Holy Spirit, it gave me peace. That gave me peace. I thank you for the video that I've made. And I thank the Lord for saying, sanctifying, and filling them with the Holy Spirit in Jesus' name. I thank you right now. And take this as a blessing for his life as we go to the closing of his life. And bro, I'll tell you, I'll see you again someday.
We need a word I'm Penny Johnson, and Warren Timothy Johnson Sr., or as a lot of us may know him as Tim, was my dad and one of my first loves. If you knew my dad, you knew he loved his family. I can remember while growing up on Sunday morning, he would make his famous plate-sized pancakes or a family game night at our house on a Friday night. He was his grandkids' favorite chef. Let me tell you, he would make this sweet spaghetti and jelly toast. If our kids wasn't jumping all over the walls already, they would soon to be. He was a great father. As me and my brothers reminisce, we had to admit we had an awesome childhood. Summer vacations to Disney World or cars in the driveway when we each turned 16 for Christmas. If anybody knew Tim, he kept his cool. His mild temper impressed me the most. My brother test drove my car to the store and hit a parked car. My dad didn't even raise his voice. He lifted an eyebrow and said, "That's why we pay insurance. We have to give them something to do with our money." His laugh took up the whole room. I could always count on him for a good laugh. Or my favorite, "Happy Friday, baby girl." I could still hear him. For the past 30 years, he was a foreman for Weekly Paving, where he gave friends and family members a trade, not just a job. Land asphalt is a skill that you could go anywhere to find work and feed your family. And my family got to eat, he always said. And that was something he took pride in. As we all say our goodbyes, take joy in knowing that my dad enjoyed his life. He was living like a 21-year-old at 60. Women still catfighting over him. Or partying from Thursday to Sunday and still having the ability to do it every weekend. And he knew the Lord. He showed mercy to a man with a loving heart and eased his pain. My dad was somewhat special to me. And the bond that we had is irreplaceable. I was his baby girl and he was my pop. I catch myself about to call him to see how his day went, but no more. Till we meet again, you are gone but never forgotten.
Hello, family, friends. I'm here to talk to you today about my cousin, Warren Timothy Johnson. Me and Tim have been hanging together since Pee Wee football till now, and growing up, every job that he got, he made sure that he got me on with him. We did so many things together. We was like the good, the bad, and the ugly, everything together. and I'm truly going to miss my cousin. I love you, man. Peace.
We fall down, but we get up. We fall down, but we get up. We fall down, but we get up. Oh, yes, for a sake.
Reflections of the life of Warren Timothy Johnson. Warren Timothy Johnson was born on October 15, 1959. Warren was lovingly called Tim by family and friends, as well as all who loved and knew him. As a child, Tim was known for getting into trouble. Once Tim had gotten deep into trouble, he knew this time it was a whopper. As our mother approached him with that "you're going to get it" look, Tim threatened to jump out of a two-story window to avoid that whooping. Our mother played along, saying, "It's okay, you're not going to get a whooping this time." Tim then opens the door, thinking all was clear, only to get that black mama whooping of his life. Tim was always hard-headed and would do whatever he chose to do, even up until the time or day that he left this earth. Tim was known for his sense of humor. Those who knew him knew he was very funny, a very funny person. Whenever Tim was around, you would most definitely laugh. You'll get a good laughing for sure. Tim was also known for his love of beautiful homes, fancy cars, and motorcycle riding. And good food wasn't far off the list. He loved eating baby donuts. Tim just loved food, period. Tim loved life. He loved his family. He was an old slash young soul. Whoever he needed to be at the time, that's who he was. Tim was a very hard worker. Since the age of 18, he worked for Weekly Corporation. And with hard work, he became the boss. Focused and stern. Nobody liked him as a boss, but off the job, he was well loved by many. Tim understood dedication and hard work would go a long ways, going to leave this earth, and begin to seek help from God. He began to look at life differently. He began to change and started listening to his Bible and sought out messages from the Word of God. Tim wanted more, and he knew he needed to accept Jesus Christ as his Lord and Savior. And he did. At the end of his journey, he realized God was in control, and he submitted his life totally and completely to God. Tim is survived by his wife, Cynthia Johnson, his children, Penny, Warren Jr., Matthew, and Jeremiah, and a host of grandchildren, his six surviving siblings, and a host of family and friends.